In this month's episode, Chinese stars sweep titles on international return, a behind-the-scenes look at player safety measures, WTT Macau offers a glimpse into the future, and more. Welcome to the ITTF Monthly Podcast brought to you by Nitaku. Each month, Nitaku is giving away a piece of gear to one lucky viewer. For your chance to win, just answer this month's Podcast question. Which player from Korea Republic secured an impressive podium finish at the 2020 ITTF Finals? To enter the draw, comment your answer below the Podcast post on ITTF's Facebook page and remember to share the episode with your friends. The winner will be picked at random. Weihai, China played host to the first international table tennis action since March, welcoming 21 of the sport's finest players to the first stop on the Restart Series, the Dishong 2020 ITTF Women's World Cup, from November 8th through the 10th. With the top 8 seeded players advancing directly to the main draw, 13 players battled it out for the remaining 8 tickets up for grabs in the group stage. The biggest surprise came in Group 3 as USA's Wu Yue earned an impressive win over 2015 bronze medalist Patricia Solya to move through at the Germans' expense. Another Pan-American star to catch the eye was Adriana Diaz. With the Puerto Rican progressing beyond the group stage for the first time in her career, with victories over Canada's Mo Zhang and Ukraine's Margarita Pesotska.
Beautiful. Fantastic job done by Diaz.
The Chinese Taipei team's Chun Tsuyu was amongst the list of players to produce show-stopping performances in the round of 16, fighting back from 1-3 down to defeat 8th seed Du Hoi Kem in a 4-3 thriller. The star performer at the event 1 year earlier, USA's Lily Zhang, avenged her bronze medal match defeat to Singapore icon Feng Tianwei, eliminating the number 5 seed with a mesmerizing 6-game win in their battle.
That's it.
Defensive specialist Han Ying of Germany gave a strong showing in her round of 16 encounter with Austria's Sofia Polkanova, edging out an exciting all-European affair. The number 14 seed from Germany was the star of the show one round later, battling past 4th seed Zheng Yijing 4-2 to reach the semi-finals.
Oh my god, a defensive player.
Han then came up with another incredible display to push China's Chun Meng right down to the wire, with the top-seeded Chinese player narrowly holding on to seal her spot in the final.
She really worked for it.
Sunying Xia was the other player to reach the gold medal showdown following her 4-2 success over Japanese second seed Mima Ito.
This is it.
Who finished her campaign on a high, beating Han Ying to the bronze medal. The final itself opened in the tightest possible fashion, with Sunying Xia establishing an early lead. Staring in the face of history, Chun Meng hit back, claiming the next 4 games in a row to lift the Women's World Cup for the first time.
covered from both sides. My God. This is it. Tenno got it. She has overcome her teammate, Sun Yingsha.
No time to rest. The second event of the month arrived hot on the heels of the first, with Weihai also playing host to the Dishong 2020 ITTF Men's World Cup from November 13th through the 15th. Just as was the case with the Women's World Cup, 13 competitors were placed across four groups in the race to reach the main draw, with five players falling at the first hurdle. As anticipated, the four highest-seeded players in group action all secured their passage to the round of 16. The big story of the group stage came courtesy of number 18 seed Darko Jordanich, who became the first Slovenian to reach the main event with a notable victory over Nigeria's Quadri Aruna.
There you go.
11-4.
Lifting the cup in 2017, Germany's Dmitry Ovcharov prevailed in one of the standout round of 16 fixtures, holding off a brave effort from in-form Englishman Liam Pitchford. Meanwhile, it was a great round for Korea Republic, with Jung Young-shik and Jang Woo-jin producing major upsets in their respective encounters with Brazil's Hugo Calderano and Japan's Koki Niwa. The two Koreans then met face-to-face in an epic quarterfinal matchup played out across six entertaining games. The match eventually went in favor of tournament debutante Jang Woo-jin by a 4-2 margin.
For him, played out completely convincingly.
There was a battle of champions in the lower section of the draw, which saw Chinese superstar Ma Long eliminate Dmitry Ovcharov.
That's it. Ma Long did his job.
And Ma Long was just as relentless in the semifinals, pulling off a mighty comeback to win against Tomokazu Harimoto.
11-4.
In the corresponding semifinal, defending champion Fan Zhendong breezed past 12th seed Zhang Wujin in straight games.
Fun, without too much surprise, nailed it.
Before going on to edge out fellow countryman Ma Long 4-3 to take home his third consecutive trophy at the event and his fourth in total.
Oh, he got it. Fan Zhendong, nice return there. Our defending champion has successfully defended the title here for the fourth time. He has won it.
The bronze medal match also required the full match distance, as Tomokazu Harimoto held the upper hand over Jang Woo-jin. The end of the year crowning moment of the ITTF calendar, the Bank of Communications 2020 ITTF Finals descended upon Zhengzhou, China from November 19th through the 22nd, as spectators made their long-awaited return to the stands. Knockout procedure in place right from the opening point, the first big name departure came in the very first match, as Korea Republic's Seo Hyo-won toppled 2014 women's singles champion Kasumi Ishikawa 4-1. A very strong round for the Asian continent. There was one European who managed to negotiate the round of 16, with Germany's Patricia Solja securing a noteworthy 4-2 win over 2010 World Team Championships gold medalist Feng Tianwei. First-round heroes, Su and Solja, continued to show great bravery in the quarterfinals, only to hit a brick wall against Chun Meng and Sun Yingsha, respectively.
Congrats, Sun Yingsha.
While Wang Manyu ensured a third spot on the podium for China with victory over the Chinese Taipei team's Zheng Yijing.
Beautiful.
Japan's Mima Ito prevented an all-China podium lockout, emerging victorious in a seven-game spectacle with Wang Yidi. With both penultimate round bouts resulting in straight game successes,
this is it! She did it!
Chun Meng and Wang Manyu set up a head-to-head title decider for the second year running. Prevailing over five games in the 2019 final, top seed Chun took the plaudits by the same margin this time out to claim the prestigious title for the fourth year in a row.
This is it! Chun Meng finally with her back and flick, making that championship point become true! She is now the true champion! Congratulations to her!
One of the brightest emerging talents on the men's singles scene, the Chinese Taipei team's Lin Winru enjoyed a winning start to his ITTF finals campaign, with the teenage ace seeing off Dmitry Ovcharov 4-2. The other teenager in the draw experienced a different fate as Zhang Wujin avenged his men's World Cup defeat with victory over 17-year-old star Tomokazu Harimoto. The breakthrough player of the restart series, Korea's Zhang Wujin added another impressive win to his collection with fifth seed Lin Gaoyuan, the next player to taste his wrath, resulting in a guaranteed podium finish for Zhang. Spectators were also treated to a repeat of the 2019 World Championships final as Ma Long came through another tantalizing encounter with Sweden's Mattias Falk.
Wow, too beautiful! Close to body shot.
Ma Long survived a stern semi-final test against Xu Xin, setting up another epic title showdown with Fan Zhendong in the process.
Short return. Xu Xin sending the ball into the net.
Defeated by his Chinese colleague at the 2019 ITTF Finals, and more recently at the 2020 Men's World Cup, Ma Long's fortunes were reversed this time around as the Dragons secured a record sixth ITTF Finals singles crown.
Oh my God, he got it, Ma Long! Celebrating that moment, the sixth champion of the tournament, Ma Long, congratulations to him!
Bringing about the much-anticipated return of international table tennis, the restart series offered fans the opportunity to see their favorite stars meet in fierce rivalry once again. All of this, however, was only made possible thanks to months of hard work and planning behind the scenes. Following in-depth consultations with experts, the ITTF compiled a list of effective measures to ensure a COVID-secure environment for all parties involved in bringing the action to life, leaving players feeling safe and secure throughout their stay in China. Everything was conducted under strict guidelines, from vast testing to player transport, to keeping the player venues safe with no expense spared. Be sure to head over to ittf.com for a comprehensive look at the work put in behind the scenes to make Restart a reality. The start of a brand new chapter in the story of international table tennis, the first glimpse into the sport's future was put on display from November 25th through the 29th with the arrival of WTT Macau, presented by Galaxy Entertainment Group. This special showcase event offered a teaser of what's to come when World Table Tennis arrives in 2021. WTT Macau featured an elite player roster in exciting new surrounds. An innovative scoring system, utilizing sudden death points, first to five games, and more, WTT Macau also raised the stakes in the top four seed battle, granting preferential order in selecting quarterfinal opposition to the best performers. Opening with the battle rounds, there was quite the upset in Battle 2 on the men's singles side, with 16th seed Fang Bo eliminating 5th seed Lin Winru in a dramatic five-game affair.
Fang Bo takes it! What a match!
Over in the top four seed battle, it was Xu Xin who held all the right cards, coming through razor-thin matches against Hugo Calderano and Ma Long to claim top pick in the quarterfinal draw. Opting for Matthias Falk, top seed Xu Xin was left stunned by the Swede, who secured his first ever win over the Cloudwalker in Macau.
Boom!
Another quarterfinal upset arrived soon after, as number 7 seed Wang Chuqin ousted 4th seed Hugo Calderano 3-2.
He popped the receive! Wang's kept his composure!
Holding off Korea Republic's Jung Young Shik in a tight head-to-head, Ma Long followed up with a more convincing display against Lin Gao Yuan to reach the first ever WTT men's singles final.
And Ma Long wins it on the scoop, the slice.
Meeting next generation stardom at the first hurdle, Ma Long couldn't afford to take his foot off the gas against Wang Chuqin. And after 6 grueling games, the title was his.
Considered the greatest of all time, gets his name in the history books, the first ever world table tennis champion.
An up-and-coming talent from Chinese shores, Liu Weishan stood out in women's singles Battle 1 with a solid win over Korean defender Seo-hyo Won.
Gone round on the backhand corner as well, that one's from the wide forehand. She goes for the attack! So we're at match point already for Liu Weishan.
Only one needed. There she goes.
While Lily Zhang needed just 3 games to condemn Patricia Solya to the same fate.
Only one needed, Johnny. Lily Zhang takes the match 3-0.
There were no major shocks in Battle 2, although Feng Tianwei did taste sweet revenge over Zhang, having lost out to the American earlier in the month.
And there we go. Feng Tianwei takes the match.
In the top 4 seed battle, it was Wang Manyu who stood victorious. Down to the final 8, Chun Xingtong turned up the heat as she recovered from a 2-game deficit to see off Olympic champion Ding Ning 3-2.
The first point's unbelievable. This is crazy. Are you serious? Get away.
The number 8 seed wasn't done there, completing another comeback win in the semifinals. Down 0-3, Chun Xingtong overcame big title favorite Chun Meng in a 7-game nail biter.
She's played the fast topspin serve, she's back lobbing. And it's gone down the line, it's the clear winner.
Through to the final, Chun Xingtong's opponent in the title decider would be none other than Sun Ying Xia, following her win over top seed Wang Manyu. Seated 6 positions higher than her compatriot, Sun Ying Xia was made to work hard by Chun Xingtong in the final and was rewarded for her determination and great composure, laying her hands on the trophy with a 5-1 win.
Final, $25,000 to win the final. There she is. Sun Ying Xia is the WTT Macau champion.
World Table Tennis has welcomed global industry leader Coca-Cola on board as WTT's first ever partner in the modern era of sport. Coca-Cola will be the official beverage partner for WTT events in China during 2021, the year in which WTT embarks on its mission to revolutionize table tennis by launching a brand new series of international events. Coca-Cola will enjoy exclusivity across the categories of water, energy drinks and soft drinks at WTT events in China, just as was the case at WTT's November showpiece event, WTT Macau. China is set to host the very first Grand Smash, the top tier in professional table tennis, among other new look WTT events in 2021. The ITTF Executive Committee met on November 11th to discuss the latest situation for international table tennis amidst the COVID-19 pandemic. Based on experiences gained during preparations for the restart series in China, the committee discussed at length the possibility for the World Team Table Tennis Championships to be held in Busan, Korea Republic in February 2021. Important discussions surrounding the qualification picture for the Tokyo 2020 Olympic and Paralympic Games were also held during the meeting, while the cancellation of all Continental Para Table Tennis Championships scheduled for 2021 was confirmed. Before we go, it's time for November's Match Point, showcasing some of the very best points from Restart.
Nice catch.
Nice retrieval from Chen Meng, yes. Look at the acceleration. Oh, that's beautiful, simply beautiful. What a long rally right there with Sun Yingsha finishing the winning point.
It was a really nice shot, like the spin rallies.
Oh, this is again beautiful. Changing direction. Still there. Too good from Carterano. Finishing with his top spin, cross court, earning that point. Wow. Oh, the good return from Adriana. Nice rally.
Wow. Absolutely incredible.
Oh, back and forehand, also, you know, all over the court. Good return from Fan Zhendong. Counterattack. That's just beautiful. Oh my God.
That's it for this month's podcast. I've been your host, Adam Bobro, and be sure to join us again as we review even more table tennis action from around the world.